So what are inappropriate words and what are incomprehensible sounds? Inappropriate words are, you recognize what words they are saying. He speaks out words, but these words don't make a sentence. They don't make a meaning. So this gives a score of V3. And if he just mumbles, you will be not be able to identify definite words in it. Only few syllables or letters or sounds. So this gives a score of 2. And as usual, V1 is no response. So now you have got all the 3 score for eye opening, verbal response and the motor response. So how do you give the total score? You add 3 of them, give the total score. And how do you report it to the physician? Do you give the total score or the individual components? No, you need to give both. You need to give both. Because the Glasgow Coma Scale, the total score is plotted on a graph. So it gives an early indication that something wrong is happening. Any fall in the graph gives an early indication. So it is a protocol that you plot the total score and also the component score in the graphs. Okay. So what is the importance of Glasgow Coma Scale? I said apart from the monitoring, it helps in prognosis. So this chart clearly says if the Glasgow Coma Scale in the first 24 hours is good, 11 to 15, the chances of recovery is very high. But if the initial Glasgow Coma Scale within 24 hours is low, this is after resuscitation, the chances of recovery are less. But is this Glasgow Coma Score infallible? In spite of so many efforts, there are fallacies in the Glasgow Coma Scale. As Madam has said, pupillary response is a very important monitoring tool for in the neurology and neurosurgery. Glasgow Coma Scale doesn't incorporate the pupillary assessment. It does not incorporate brainstem reflexes. So that you have to monitor that separately apart from this. Second one. Suppose the patient has an eye injury. There is swelling of the eyes. Can I assess the eye response? It's difficult. Suppose there is a Turner palsy, there is a ptosis. In that case, I will not be able to assess the eye response. Similarly, all these things are confounding. If the patient is intubated or had a tracheostomy, can I assess the verbal response? No. In that way, at least you indicate saying verbal response is I, RT, saying that either intubated or on tracheostomy. And all these things. And one more thing which I forgot to say, before assessing the Glasgow Coma Scale, you need to have a proper idea regarding the clinical history of the patient. Suppose the patient has an hemiplegia, you'll have to assess for the motor response on the opposite side. Because the power is 0, there is no point in me assessing the motor response. Until what age can I apply this Glasgow Coma Scale? Can I apply it on an infant? So what is the age limit? Variously stated, somewhere more than 4 years or 5 years, I can apply this score. If it's below 4 or 5 years, I will have to use an alternative score. This is the modified score for children. The motor response and eye opening are nearly same. You needn't remember them differently. But for the verbal response, it changes. Thank you.